All right, now I finally got the technical bugs worked out, and everything should be working great here. How is everyone? I have mentioned many times in many videos, tune out the news because we're entering a very bad time. I've said also that virtually every day there's going to be shootings, mass shootings. It's going to be more and more and more and more. You have to tune it out somehow. Now, situations like this require a profound response. And what the world, the disagreement in the world is over what constitutes a profound response. It's a tremendous disagreement. What I see as the media and most people, their responses are trivial. They're like crumbs. And then they give trivial responses to it. And then there are more trivial responses piled on top of that, and then more piled on top of that. And you have a chain reaction of triviality, of crumbs, getting crumbs. Any question that arises deserves a profound response. Anything, any situation deserves a profound response. And we don't get that in this world. Especially in the media, we don't get it, which is why I say stop watching the media, stop watching the news, even on the internet, anywhere. You're not getting that profound response that you deserve. You deserve better than what they have. So there is this tremendous divide about what constitutes a profound response. And the first thing that we all need to realize is that compromise is not a profound response. Can't possibly be, right? Because those who give trivial responses will say, well, let's compromise between your profound response and a trivial response. What do you get then? A mixed up mush of confusion. That is not profound at all. So compromise is never profound. It's never a profound response. So I'm held back and checked because of my circumstances. I cannot really give a full-on profound response. I can give a similitude of it here, but not a complete, wholehearted totality of a profound response. And I keep trying to get in a situation that will enable me to do that, because, again, there are disagreements. You need to be in a situation where you're not threatened by those who disagree with your what you see as profound, because those who dwell in the trivial and giving out crumbs, they follow the guide of their guide is the ego, is the belief system, which is the hypothetical scenario, and that belief system will tell them that they need to destroy, get rid of anybody who is opposed to its so-called profound response, which is actually trivial. And so really, people do take steps to undermine those who they feel are, from the standpoint of belief, those who feel that they're not agreeing that the trivial is somehow profound. And they believe that the profundity of it comes from the agreement that it is profound. They believe that a trivial response becomes profound when numbers, huge amounts of people say, yeah, we'll accept that as profound. That's how illusions work. Illusions believe they become real if they just get everybody to agree they're real, which is completely insane. So I'm in a situation that I need to improve. There's no question about it. And that's very frustrating, because I could be doing a lot better, really. Because the times always in this world call for a profound response, never more so than the times we're entering now. True profundity is required, and it's just not available in the world. I can't find it. I can't give it myself, really. I know how it could be, for sure. And I've been trying my very best in these videos to give profound responses. Alerting you ahead of time is a profound response. I told you these things will happen, no question about it. The wheels are coming off. The wheels are coming off. And yet there's more to it. There's more to it. The profundity can be greater. There's no question. So that's one thing that I can say here, which is at least helpful, is the profundity can become much greater. Much greater. Will it? It should. And I don't see why it is not. It is just some little stumbling block. It's just really frustrating. There should be people coming out and delivering a profound response full on at this time. in your face without fear of retribution, in a protected situation where the fear of retribution is minimized, at least immediate retribution is minimized. Because profound responses will bring the desire for retribution from belief, and belief will tell those who are loyal to belief to bring about retribution. Definitely will. Because it's an affront. Belief feels that's an extreme affront for anyone to come out with a profound response, because belief peddles triviality, crumbs. Imagine someone who made their life selling crumbs for food and telling everybody this was the best food possible, the most food possible, that this is the greatest ever. And that was their entire identity was based on that, everything. And then someone came along and dished out big, huge, wonderful, hearty meals. Here you go. They would say, oh my gosh, this is going to undermine my business, you see. Because people realize that I've just been peddling crumbs. We can't have that. And so they try to put the one who is giving the full meal, they try to put him out of business. That's how the world works. So it is a very aggravating shortcoming right now at this time that I'm very aggravated by it, and working super hard this morning. I work so hard. I work every day to find out why am I not aligning with a better situation. It's just incredible, because I know these things are coming. I've said they're coming. I've seen it. Definitely, we are entering a time of madness. Extreme weirdness, and that requires a profound response. Everything in this world requires a profound response. The totality of the situation requires a profound response. Only a profound response will truly satisfy you and get you gravitating towards accepting reality as it is, instead of trying to accommodate the notion of a changed reality, which we don't realize is actually an annihilated reality. This is something that you have to dig very deep to see this. That what we're really dealing with in existence is trying to survive the annihilation of reality. And you have to dig very deep. Existence won't tell you this. Will not. It hides this from you by doling out these little things of little bits of annihilation, and seeing how do you respond to that. So this is the game that existence plays. Existence is a death game. Is an annihilation game. And of course you're going to run into all sorts of annihilation scenarios of all different types. And then you're expected to respond to those as if, okay, how do we overcome this? How do we survive this and react to it and all this kind of stuff? Instead of a truly profound response for using these situations as a teaching moment to saying, look, how about dropping existence altogether? How about setting it down and saying, we don't need this at all. We don't need this crazy game at all. How about that? That's a profound response. And it goes on from there about clearly showing you how to do it. And yet it becomes more profound by radiating the certitude, by not reacting to anything that's happening in this world, actually, is a profound response. And of course, if you do that, if you are like completely blissful and not reacting to anything that happened in the world, people will say you're crazy, that this is a trivial response. You should be in grief. You should be all upset. You should be frantic. Say, oh my gosh, annihilation is still at our doorstep. What do we do? What do we do? And yet those who recognize that this notion of annihilation is totally unnecessary to entertain it, because it will never happen, then they realize that this is all just a complete imagination, a play of imagination, and it's completely unnecessary. So they are blissfully radiating to you the non-necessity of it, which frees you from all of it, which shows you the way to be free. So you don't need to react to anything in this world. You need to be free of the world. Being free of the world is not a reaction to it. It's accepting reality as it is. It's an acceptance rather than a reaction. So we have to have those who have accepted reality as it is during this time. Have to have it. And in the situation I'm in right now, I can't do that wholeheartedly. Not able to do it. Because there'd be retributions, for sure. So I'm frustrated because I'm still stuck at the level of words. Which are not sufficient, as we can feel it, that going forward words will not be sufficient, which I've been preaching on it. They're not. You have to have the whole thing. The whole show has got to be going on. The whole show. The show of reassurance has to be taking place. Now, I'm somewhat of an expert on depression. and I can talk about it, but during these times we need the whole show. So just because I can explain depression, understand it, having gotten out of the darkest, deepest depression possible and gotten out of it, I understand what it's about, which is attempt to be loyal to both truth and lies. That's what causes depression, which is really an inevitability for all of us. At some point we will stop trying to believe that lies are true, and then we'll see that truth is true, and then we'll say, wait a minute, I got to accommodate both of these viewpoints, and then that leads to depression. The question is not will we get depressed, it's how do we get out of it as fast as possible. That is what I look at it as. Whereas lies say, oh no, you never have to go through that. All you have to do is make lies true, and then you never have to go through that. You can never make lies true. What happens is the longer you try to make lies true, the more difficult the depression will be, because you'll be more loyal and familiar with lies. So I'm definitely have a great deal of expertise with depression and the clarity of it and understanding the totality of the situation. And yet we are going into a situation where the whole show has to be present. It's not enough to be an expert on something. You have to be an expert on everything. You have to be an expert on existence itself. And that has to be expressed beyond words. Has to be. There is no other option for that. And the problem is if you're expressing it beyond words, people will think you're crazy because you're not responding to the world. What happens? You don't respond at all. You're unaware. I accidentally heard about this latest situation by listening to a sports talk station, and they broke in breaking news, and they brought this news. I didn't want to hear that because I already know the gist of existence. It doesn't matter how death comes. Death comes for everyone. Annihilation comes for everyone. At least the dream of annihilation affects all illusions. Everything within the dream is subject to the dynamic of the dream. And the answer is to drop the dream. Stop dreaming the dream. That's the answer. And then how do we do that? Well, we have to be reassured that that's okay to do that. And that reassurance has to be beyond words, because words don't have certainty. They're entirely dependent on our interpretation of them. So the whole show has to get on the road at this time. The whole show. And I know I keep saying that. And every day I wake up, I say that's my focus is something has to change, something has to get better, something has to, the whole show has to get underway. Otherwise, we will just continually be hit with domino after domino after domino after domino, as we have been hit for quite some time now. The dominoes are simply falling. It's really a domino effect that's taking place. The first domino was 2001, and the dominoes have been falling ever since. And we're getting into a place now, as you see a whole domino maze set up, right? You see people that set up these vast, complex mazes of dominoes, and you watch them fall. You know that there's certain sections where suddenly, like one domino will fall and it will hit like three other ones, and those three other ones will each hit three other ones, and then suddenly there's 3 paths, and each path is 9 paths. Will be 9 paths suddenly, all going, and maybe those other three hit three others, and there's 27 paths going, all at once. You see how it gets exponential. And we're right at the cusp of exponentiality. That's December 21, 2012. Is that moment of exponentiality. And at that point, you know, it's not business as usual. And you will suddenly realize, oh my gosh, we need something better than words. We need something that's exponentially better than words. Exponentially better. The best explanation possible is not going to be good enough. I can give very, very clear explanations, but they're not going to be good enough. And I'm aware of that. That's why I'm very concerned, because I'm still not in a situation that will, where I can see that it can open up to the full show, can be on display of certitude. Certitude really has to put on a show for those who, so those who want a profound response can say, okay, this is where the profound response is. Now, if you're like a food server, like a waitress or a waiter or waitress, and you've worked there, or serving meals at home, you know the difference between serving a plate that has a few little crumbs on it and a plate that's got a full course meal on it. Obviously. Now, how long does it take to discern if you have two waitresses are bringing in some food? Each one has a plate. On one plate is just a few little crumbs. On another plate is a full course meal, wonderful meal. How long does it take you to discern which is the full course meal and which is the crumbs? Boom! Instantaneously, isn't it? You're not sit there and go, okay, now, let me see if I can figure this out. Just one moment. I'm going to click over here. Just one moment. So, where is the, there it is, okay. Words are not enough. I mean, that's the statement, Words are not enough. They are not enough. You have to radiate certitude at this point in time. So the dominoes are falling, and we need to come up with what is important. Now, anything else I can say here? Rapidly words are not becoming enough. You can feel that. And that is a huge concern I have. I have a feeling like, you know, this situation here with words is running its course. Because it won't be sufficient. Now, words as an adjunct are helpful. But by themselves, they only can point out the necessity for something better. They point out the necessity for something better. So I am continuing to implore the grace of God to act beyond words. I mean, there are practical actions that have to be taken. We cannot just be stuck with words. Cannot at this time. Otherwise, we'll all sink down to the situation, because as exponentiality arises, the trivial responses will also become exponential. And we will be pulled into words in a trivial manner, in a very trivial manner. And if we try to speak in a non-trivial manner, that we will feel a tremendous backlash, as if we're somehow have no compassion, no feeling, no humanity, no sense, no goodness, no righteousness, no sanity. All these things will be present. Again, you see that plate. How long does it take for you to recognize this one's got crumbs and this one's a full course meal? It, boom, like that. It doesn't take any thought to recognize that. It's inherently recognizable. So when there's a radiation of certitude, it is inherently recognizable. You say, this is a full course meal, and the other stuff in the world's offering are crumbs. It's completely inherently recognizable. There's no thought necessary for that. There's no words necessary for that. It's obvious. Completely, just as obvious as you looking at two plates, one with you little crumbs and the other with a full course meal on it. It doesn't take any intelligence at all to instantly recognize the difference. So we have the capacity to instantly recognize the difference. It's just that belief insists we don't have the capacity, because why? Because we've always been looking at plates with crumbs on them. And trying to say which plate has more crumbs, and that's hard. Like this one has, you know, 20 large crumbs, and this one has 120 small crumbs. And we're trying to say, wait a minute, which one has more crumbs? Well, let me count the crumbs here. We're involved in that, so we think we need to exercise all this judgment. We don't need to exercise any judgment at all in the world. That's the final judgment, that everything here is unnecessary, totally, equally unnecessary. Therefore, there's no need for any judgment whatsoever. That in our mind, free of judgment. It's all this constant judgment that we're engaged in. It drags us down, drags us down, drags us down. And so we are entering a time now where we either make the final judgment or we get enmeshed in unbelievable number of judgments where we say, oh my gosh, I'm going to need 10 lifetimes to make all these judgments. And then you stratify yourself out into 10 lifetimes. In other words, another cycle. You sign up for another cycle out of a sense of being overwhelmed. And you'll say, gosh, I need another cycle to sort this all out. And I need maybe, 10 lifetimes, 20 lifetimes, 100 lifetimes, whatever. And you will sign up for that thinking that you need it. So that's why we're in a very dangerous time right now. You don't want to sign up for more lifetimes. You don't want to sign up for another cycle. And you don't need to pass any judgment at all upon the world except that it doesn't need any judgment. Doesn't need any judgment. The fact that it's unnecessary isn't a judgment. It's completely obvious. It's inherently obvious that hypothetical, you don't need to engage this hypothetical because reality can never be annihilated or even threatened in the slightest bit, in the slightest way. So it's all totally unnecessary. There's no judgment even needed at all. So the final judgment is that you don't need to exercise any judgment at all upon, no judgment upon the world, and that in itself isn't even a judgment. It's just inherently obvious. That is what we have to have. So we have to have someone who has made that final judgment. And many in the world now. So we can determine, okay, that's profound. And decide, what's profound? Is it watching some talking head reading copy a teleprompter on the news? Or a teleprompter anywhere? Is that profound? Or is it profound that one who has realized that the world doesn't need any judgment, they're abiding in perfect certitude, giving us radiating assurance to us? Or is that profound? Sanitation engineers. Wonderful guys. What would we do without them? What would we do without them here? Hey, you can hear them coming from a long ways away, right? And when they come, that's when stuff happens. Fast. Fast, 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 fast. And that's the time we're in right now. It's a time when the garbage cans get poof, 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 poof. Existence doesn't need any judgment upon it at all, except to say that it's completely unnecessary, and that's an inherent recognition. Instantaneous recognition doesn't require any thought whatsoever. Does not require thought to make that determination. Accept reality as it is, and you will know entertaining this hypothetical is unnecessary. Entertaining any hypothetical is unnecessary. But the hypothetical of annihilation, again, is unnecessary, completely unnecessary. So, that which is radiating this assurance, this certitude, no judgment necessary, realize this is all totally unnecessary, that is what is needed right now. That is what is needed. And we will see that's profound. Otherwise, we are going to be listening to a teleprompter talk. Teleprompter talk after teleprompter talk after teleprompter talk. All these talking heads, simply reading copy. And somewhere deep within you, you realize this is not profound at all. This is horrible. But then you say, well, where do I go for what's profound? Where do I go? Because in times like this, we want to feel reassured, the whole picture, the whole thing. And hugging people, so that's not profound either. We realize, we just kind of said, well, hey, this is terrible. Things are terrible, but we'll help each other through somehow. So, meanwhile, you sign up for another tour of duty, 10 lives, another cycle, whatever, because you think, oh, I gotta figure this all out. I have to judge this accurately. And how can I possibly do that right now? It's going to take a long time. And of course, if anyone who's free, they'll say, oh, how did you manage to judge everything like that? It must have taken you a long, long time. No, it doesn't take any time at all to not judge. And the fact is, you don't need to judge. So you, even if you're a child, you can awaken right this moment. You don't need any time whatsoever. It's nonsense to think that somehow expertise is based on time. Expertise is not based on time. It's recognizing that time is not necessary. That's expertise. taking the step beyond time into eternity is like right now. It doesn't take any time. You can do it if you're a baby, a child, teenager, adolescent. You can do it as a young adult, as a middle-aged adult, older adult, mature adult, golden ages, real old, etc. Any time at all, you can step beyond time into eternity. It takes no time at all. It takes but an instant. And then you will truly be the true expert, the true, and radiate assurance. And you can do that right now. One of the ways I got stuck is people saying, how can you be an expert? You're so young. When I was young, I tried to convey something to the world, really. And the world said, well, you sound like an expert, but that's not possible. You couldn't possibly be because you haven't had the time to become an expert. Of course, they're ignoring all my previous lives, right? They think that I'm a tabula rasa. I was just born yesterday. I have never had any experience at all in the world. So how could I possibly be an expert? And they said, well, maybe when you're really older, you might be an expert. So I waited all this time thinking, okay, now I'm old. Quite a bit older, and maybe people believe I'm an expert now. This is totally stupid. You know, I really regret the incredible stupidity of falling for that trap. But there's just so much pressure in this world. It's tough for young people to wake up because people will say, how can you be an expert? Well, I'm telling you, if you're young, you can wake up right now. Don't wait another second. Don't wait for any older people to tell you that you have to wait to be an expert, because how could you be an expert already? No, you've had many, many, many previous lives, many, many previous cycles. You might be already know the truth that you don't. This world needs no judgment. Existence needs no judgment. And therefore, you can wake up right now. You can step beyond time right now. And it has nothing to do with how long you've been alive in this life. Nothing to do with it. Nothing to do with it. So don't wait for me. Don't wait for anybody. And I wish somebody had told me that when I was young. Nobody told me that. They said you had a lot of potential. That P word, that horrible P word. Even the so-called spiritual masters and those who work told me that. He said, you have a lot of potential. What an absolute nonsense. You can say that about anybody. You have a lot of potential. Meaning you need time to develop it. That is total BS. You can step beyond time right this instant. Everyone can. Forget about potential. What do you need time for? You don't need time for anything. You absolutely do not need time for anything whatsoever. Because everything you need is right here, right now. Reality is here right now. You can accept reality as it is right now. You can recognize you don't need to judge existence at all. It's totally unnecessary. You can do that right now. You don't need time for that. You don't need time for any learning. Time is learning. You don't need to learn anything. Nobody needs to learn anything here whatsoever. So what do you need time for? What do you need age for? You don't. You don't. Nobody needs it. So I got this nonsense from older people who are supposedly spiritually advanced that I had potential. If they should have told me that, no, you can wake up right now. You don't need to wait the slightest second. I said, no, you got potential, but you got to develop a lot of this and blah, blah. What a bunch of total bull. Totally. And since these so-called spiritual adepts were telling other people this about me, you know, I got all this pressure come on me that I wasn't ready yet or something. You're always ready. Everybody is always ready. They're always ready, but they're just trying to please belief too. You can't please both belief and reality. It's impossible. Cannot please them both. You can't please a lie and truth both. You cannot. And if you step beyond people, say, well, who do you think you are? You haven't gone through all these initiations, and you're not a master, and all that blah blah blah. Total nonsense. Total nonsense. You don't have to go beyond anything. Accept all of existence all at once. That doesn't require any spiritual mastery whatsoever. It doesn't require any learning whatsoever. Because reality is already present for you. you just abide in the arms of reality as it is. Doesn't require any learning to do that. Doesn't require any time. Doesn't require any development within this hypothetical. None. And you just see that existence is totally unnecessary. Always has been from the very beginning. Always will be. And that takes no time or learning whatsoever. It's inherent recognition. So these are the words I wish someone had told me, and did not. I don't know why. That's something that I'm not pleased about at all. So what I say oftentimes is what I wish someone had told me when I was younger. It would have saved me a lot of time. And of course, the pressures in the world from those who insist that you need time are very severe here. And maybe the voice that was telling me that I couldn't be heard or was ignored, or there's so much pressure I felt I better not listen to it or something. But come on, we can do so much better with the teaching. Just be so much more adamant about it. And stick with the adamancy, because all this other stuff is not really helpful. You have to be adamant. If the teaching you're listening to is not adamant, forget it. Forget it. You're taking the slow boat, taking a real slow boat, and you don't need it. You don't need any time at all. That is the best teaching, is just constantly reminding you don't need another moment. Nobody does. Nobody, absolutely nothing in this hypothetical needs another moment. And all those aspects of spirit who are identifying with this don't need another moment. In fact, never needed any moment. Never will. Never will. Just to inherently recognize, this was all completely unnecessary. It's totally unnecessary. It was always completely unnecessary. No learning is needed for that. No learning whatsoever. Reject all the learning that existence holds out to us as if it's important. It's totally unimportant. Totally. And these are the words that need to be said, and yet the whole show needs to get on the road. The whole thing, the whole package needs to be there. It's not enough for words anymore. Yet the words have to be adamant, and yet there's something behind it. It has to be even more adamant than these words. So I'm trying to give the most adamant words possible, but at some point that's not even going to be enough. And so we have to prepare for those times, and those times are here. Those times are very much here, and I've been working like crazy to prepare, just nonstop, 15 years of all-out effort, and continue to try and accelerate. And still, it's coming up short, which is not a good thing. But hopefully, adamantly, I don't want to come up short. So I want the whole show to get on the road, but I'm pretty much limited right now to doing this. In the situation that where I'm at, I'm pretty much limited to doing this. And I've been trying to see, can I do some more? Then things would get pretty darn stressful for me. But I will keep trying and keep trying and keep praying and keep listening for an answer. What is the answer? Because I can be adamant with my words easily. But again, that's not enough. That is not enough at this point. In one ear and out the other. At this time, people are getting so distracted in one ear and out the other. Again, I've been very adamant on this video, but how much has it stuck within? And say, yeah, it's resonating within. See, we have to resonate now with something, with profundity. What we feel is profound, we need to resonate with that now. Really. Resonate with it. Beyond words, beyond the flesh, beyond gestures, beyond all that stuff. There just has to be this quiet, profound acceptance. Start to resonate with acceptance. Resonating with acceptance is what we have to do. That resonation with this profound acceptance that we don't need to pass any judgment whatsoever on existence. It's completely unnecessary. That's all we have to recognize, and that's not even a judgment. All of it, from the very beginning, was totally unnecessary. It will always be totally unnecessary. That's it. Accept reality as it is. Gravitate in that way. And of course, there'll be miracles. There'll be, along that path, there will be various situations that arise that are very supportive. But we don't need to worry about that. We really don't. That's a trap, too, to think about that. What's important is to start resonating with assurance and with acceptance. That's all important right now. All important. So I will try to carry through the rest of this day. I have to, that the call to resonate with acceptance. Resonate with acceptance and assurance. That we need that show to get on the road, the whole production to be present. To be present right now. All right. very great, and that's exactly what I'll continue to do. That's it for this one.